And out of the hospital, back in church tonight. That's good. Thank you, brother, for being here. Appreciate you being here. We prayed for you. Let's look at Matthew 16. And I want y'all to look at this. All you teenagers, and everybody look at this scripture here. If you don't have a Bible, turn around there and look with somebody. Verse number 26. For what is a man profited if he gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? According to that verse now tonight, I'll stop there. Your soul is the most valuable possession that you have. Now, I'm going to talk about that a little bit tonight, and I'm going to preach on the value of your soul. Every one of you tonight has inside your body a soul. Better listen to me, because all your emphasis at school, all your emphasis in your community, your friend, is all on your body. We have to take care of this body. You got to wash it once in a while. You got to wash your hair, brush your teeth, all that stuff. And you should. I hope you do. I don't know if some of you, but I think we all try to take care of this body. We feed it. We give it sleep. We take care of it. We try to teach it. We try to take care of it, get sleep, exercise, whatever. But the Bible teaches that inside my body here tonight, I have a soul that is shaped just like my body. Sure do. See, inside me tonight, that's what makes you different from a dog or a cat or something. Inside me tonight, I have a soul inside me. And then inside that, there's spirit. Your body, soul, and spirit. You're like God. He's God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. And you're like that. Don't forget this. You've got a soul inside you that's going to live forever and ever somewhere. Now, this soul is like a football. If you took a football right here tonight and held it like that right there, you got one football. Now, that football has an outer leather cover. That's your body. And right inside that football or basketball is a rubber, like a balloon inside there. That's your soul. It's shaped just like that football, but you can't see it, but it's in there. And inside that rubber soul is air. That's a picture of your spirit. So you got one football, but it's body, soul, spirit. That's the way I am. I'm Danny, but I got Danny the body, Danny the soul, Danny the spirit, and that's what you are. You're Marty Bullinger, Marty the body, Marty the soul, Marty the spirit. Frankie the man, Frankie the soul, Frankie the spirit. Every one of you tonight has a soul inside you. Now, we're going to talk tonight about what the Bible talks about. You know, you hear all this stuff about people sold their souls, and I preach that sermon, they sold their soul for rock and roll, and they got one of me on the internet because they sold their soul for hip-hop, and there's been like, Lord have mercy, I mean, almost 500,000 people, 400,000 views on that thing. I didn't know it was on there, and somebody put it on there, and it's been all over the world, and it's called They Sold Their Souls for Hip-Hop. Now, you can do that. You can do that. You can lose. Now, don't. Please, there's always, when I say that, there's always somebody that writes to us and said, that's ridiculous. You can't sell your soul. Your soul ain't yours to sell. Some nut. People don't even know what they're talking about. Talk like that. Your soul ain't yours to sell. God owns all the soul. Well, you're just not a smart person that thinks like that. That book said he can lose his own soul. What it said, right? So it is yours. And you can lose it. You can lose your soul. You can lose it. Now, this bargain with the devil stuff goes on all the time. And I'm going to show it to you in a minute. People in Hollywood, just about everybody that you see who's real famous has somewhere made some kind of deal. All the singers, all the popular people like Britney Spears, you know, with Katy Perry. You know, I've got video of Katy Perry sitting in an interview saying, I tried gospel music, that didn't work, so I sold my soul to the devil. You say, well, Brother Danny, she don't really mean that. Well, Here's how smart the devil is. The devil gets you to say that, and you don't even think you mean it, but then he does it, and you really do lose your soul and lead thousands of other young ladies down that same path. The devil's smart. He ain't nobody to mess with, y'all. He's nobody to fool with. And so I'm going to talk about the value of your soul. You people are stupid that they don't even realize that your soul is the most valuable thing that you have. Inside your body is your soul. Listen to me. Your soul is going to heaven or hell. Your soul will live in forever somewhere in some place. Your soul will die and go to hell. Your soul will die, or your body will go to the grave. Your soul will go to hell. Your body will die, and your soul will go to heaven. One of those two things. Everybody sitting in here tonight, your soul will live forever and ever and ever. So quickly, let me show you this. Your soul is of more value than selfish possessions. Some people will literally sell their soul for possessions. As a matter of fact, Hollywood out there in Los Angeles, I've been to Hollywood. I've walked down them streets. I've been down them streets where they got them stars in the sidewalk. And I've seen Rodeo Drive where movie stars shop and seen them Maseratis running up and down the streets. You know what I mean? It ain't near as hot as you think it is. It's really, really a nasty place, you know. There's spit on them stars, on them sidewalk, and them people in hell. So it's really not that big a deal like they try to make it on TV. And you know what? I remember looking at them things, and I thought those people sold their soul for sinful and selfish possessions. They said, "I want to get rich. I want to get rich. I want to get rich. Well, what do I got to do? Well, you know, take your clothes off and let us film you. Okay, I'll do it." That's what happened to Sharon Stone and all them. Douglas, all them old movie stars, and now the new movie star, Brad Pitt, old Fat Lip Jolie, and all of them, you know, those men that he made those movies with, and all of them, the devil said, are you willing to do this? No, well, go on, we'll get somebody. And they got somebody in there said, are you willing to do this? Yes, I'll do it. And to get fame and fortune, that's what that is. That's a devil paying you to doom other people and paying you off and then taking your soul. That's the way this thing works. So your soul is more valuable than selfish possessions. It's more valuable than all the money in the world. It's more valuable than all the gold in the world. It's more valuable than all the silver in the world. It's more value than every car. If you had every car in America in your driveway, all stacked up together, your soul is more valuable than all those cars. If you had all the clothes, all the tennis shoes, all the blue jeans, all the cool stuff, the highest dollar phones, everything in this, all the jewelry, if you had diamonds on every finger, there's not as valuable as your soul. Your soul is more valuable than selfish possessions. You hear me? I heard about that Ariana Grande. You know who she is, that little girl sings, and all them people that got shot at her concert. You know what them people did? They paid money to get to see her. And they paid all this money to get to see her. And they're like, yeah, man. Bam. They're gone. The devil comes and gets their soul. All those people at that concert in Texas a few weeks ago, where they said them people was crowded in there so tight that you couldn't even move. It was so crowded. And all of a sudden, they said somebody was running around in there jabbing people in the neck with needles. And then they got all kind of weird. Their eyes started going backwards. And they was pushing each other against the fence. And all hell broke loose. And there's, I don't know how many people wound up dead in that concert. You know what that was? That was the devil saying, I want that one. And I want that one, and I want that one, and I want that one. And if you think the devil won't do the same thing to you, little girl, you got another thing coming. Now, young man, if you're sitting in here tonight and you say, I'm smart enough, I can handle it, nobody can. Listen, buddy, it's the goodness of God that all of us ain't in hell tonight. I think back of how the Lord took care of me. You've heard, this is my testimony. I mentioned the other night. I forgot about it for a while. But I remember when I was young, every time I was 14, 13, 12, I was playing in a rock band when I was 12 years old. And I played guitar in this band with a bunch of older boys. I had no business doing that. My mom took a fit, and Daddy hauled us around to play at dances. We used to play for the dances over at the Moose Lodge in Marion and the Lake Club in Nebo. And we played that music. And I remember every time I'd want to get real wicked, it was like the Lord put a roadblock. And I'll never forget one night. I was standing over here, and there was a band on stage like that, and they were singing. And I was standing right here like this. And that music got louder and louder and louder, and the crowd was out here. And I was like, whoa, man. And all of a sudden, I remember felt something. And I didn't hear it in my ear, but I heard it in my heart. It said, why don't you just give in? Why don't you just give in? And I remember thinking, whew. And I'm about 14, and I backed up like that. And I said, whew. It's like I was getting hypnotized or something. And I went, nah, like it. And I backed off. You know something, y'all? I forgot about that. I forgot all about that happening. And then I got saved. And when I got saved, I started preaching about music and the power that music has over young people and everything. And it's like a spirit gets in it. And I thought, wonder who that was talking to me that night. Who was it? Said, get that little boy right there. Come on, just give yourself. Now, when you know, sex, drugs, rock and roll, brother. That's the devil's three. That's his three main darts. He shoots at you. And he shoots, you get all three of them, you're in trouble. And anytime one of them, the other two shows up. They're triplets. Any misuse of either one of them, brother, the other two shows up. They all go together. And ladies and gentlemen, and I remember thinking that, and I remember thinking, something talking to me. And I got saved, and I thought, Lord have mercy, that was a demon. And I remember this lady said that she took her daughter to a concert in Charlotte. And she said, that little girl was good. She'd clean her room. She'd do anything I ask her to. And she said, when she came back from that concert, she was a different kid. And said, I never could do nothing with her after that. She sassed her mama. She's a smart aleck. She didn't want to clean her room. She said, it's almost like she got something down there and brought it home with her. And then you heard her testimony. How that when I was 15 and it was just getting ready to start basketball season, me and this boy, quote, camped out. Don't call it that. You know when you camp out and you tell your mama you're spending that with them and they tell their mama they're spending that with you and they ain't nobody spending that with nobody. Because you're out running around somewhere. You know what I mean? Just lied. And we'd done out something that night. I don't know. I was too young. We didn't have a car. I was 15 years old. But I remember we was talking and sinning and doing all stuff like that. And I remember this. I remember thinking, it don't matter. I'll do whatever I want to. I'm not going to hold back. I'm young. I'm 14, 15. I'll do what I want to. Next day, we was in his house. My mama's home praying for me. And he looked underneath the sock drawer because we'd been out that night and we dirty and camped out supposedly. And he reached in his sock drawer and pulled out a little pistol. And his daddy kept the .22 pistol in that drawer there under the socks, and they never kept it loaded or anything. But his daddy had it out and used it the day before and shot it twice. There's four bullets in that gun. And he pointed it at my chest. He pointed it right at me. And I was standing there like this. He put that thing right here and pulled that trigger and it went. That was one of them two that wasn't in there. Right here. And then he pointed at me again and I put my hand up like that and I said, get that thing out of my face. He said, you want me to shoot you? And I said, get that thing away from me. And I put my hand like that and he put it right there. And pow! Went right through my hand. You can see the scar still right there. Came out right there. And when that thing went through me, buddy, it went all the way around like that. I didn't fall down. But I remember I was staggering around like that, and blood just started squirting everywhere and going down. And I remember I walked through the house, and his mama heard the gun go off, and she come through the hallway, and she about passed out. I mean, she, and I got in there. And his dad, they put me in the car and took me to the hospital, the old hospital in Marion. And I sit there in the emergency room like that. The big pile of blood right there on the floor. Listen, you say, what does it feel like to get shot, Brother Danny? I'll tell you this so you won't ever have to find out. It feels like somebody takes takes, here's what it felt like. Somebody takes a stick of steel about that size right there and heats it in a fire where it's orange hot and holds it in your hand. That's what it felt like. It felt like it was holding fire in my hand. And I'm there, you know, seen all these movies where John Wayne and them, they get shot with a 45 and you know, jump on their horse and ride 15 miles and fight Indians. That's a bunch of bull. I ain't John Wayne, but I'm pretty tough. And you ain't going to ride no horse 15 miles and fight Indians. I didn't feel like riding no horse and fighting Indians. Brother, you can't even hardly walk. And I walked out the car like that and sat down, and that blood was all over the floor. And I remember that night, they couldn't do nothing to it, but it swelled up real big. And the doctors, give me something for pain. I don't know what they had back then, a bunch of aspirin and stuff. And I put my hand up on a pillow like that so it wouldn't swell so bad and spent that night in the hospital. And after I got saved, I looked back again. And I thought that was good. The good. If I hadn't have stuck my hand out, ain't no telling. I could be in hell right now. If he'd have shot me, I'd have died and went to hell. And you kids don't realize that's just how fast. Some of y'all are 13, 14, 15. You don't realize how you can be gone just like that. It don't take but a second. I had no business even being around that guy. None whatsoever. Your soul is more valuable than selfish possessions. Your soul is more valuable than sinful pleasures. You know what? I know people on drugs. Many, many of them. We deal with them all the time. We have kids here tonight whose parents are on drugs. We have kids here tonight whose sister is on drugs. We have people here tonight who's probably on drugs. I'm telling you tonight, the devil don't play fair. The devil don't play fair. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to show you in just a minute what happens and how valuable soul really is. Now, here's your mistake. Here's the mistake you'll make if you're not real careful. You'll make this mistake. You'll say, well, Brother Danny, I quit. I'm saved. I quit going here. I quit going there. But you'll hang on just a little bit and leave a little door open. You know why so many people that get off drugs and then they do good for a couple of months and then they go right back on drug? They just leave that door open just a little bit. You don't have to leave a door open but that much for a snake to get in. I got the ceiling closed off, got the walls closed off, and I can leave that door open that much and a snake get in. And that's where your life is. And I'm going to tell you something about a snake. You say, I got rid of my old drug dealer. I don't go see him no more, man. I just cut his head off. Let me tell you something about a snake, people. This is proven. You might not believe it. Look it up. A snake can bite you after you cut its head off. It's their nerves. I've seen them where you can cut their head off and put a stick right there and that snake will still go like that and try to bite it. You better remember that. You better remember that. Snake can bite you after you've cut its head off. I know a boy that did that. He got rid of his drug dealer. He got rid of his old girlfriends. He got rid of, see, if you're in a relationship and your boyfriend is on drugs or your girlfriend or the kids at school or whatever, you think, I'm not going to do that, but I still love you and all of that kind of stuff. Yeah, yeah. You'll get it. You'll get you. You say, well, break my heart. You know what you got to do about your heart? Sometimes you got to break your own heart. That ain't fun. Sometimes you got to break your own heart. You girls know what I'm talking about, right? You got to break your own heart and hurt a little while rather than live a life that displeased God. I'm going to show you something tonight. Jeff, you can go ahead and get those lights down. I want you to listen to this. It's only like 5 minutes or so. I'm going to show you something. How the devil will trick you about the value of your soul. Watch this. He's a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it. Watch this tonight. The devil will lie to you about the value of your soul. The devil, kids, will lie to you about, he'll make you think all is important is being popular and being good looking and getting that boyfriend or having those clothes or getting a car. He'll make you think that's all that's important. And then you get in a car wreck and die without God. You listen carefully. You watch everything I'm going to show you here tonight. Devil lies about the value of your soul. We'll see some people in Hollywood. They put a thing in a newspaper in Hollywood that you can come and sell your soul to the devil. And I want you to look at the people that lined up to sell their soul to the devil.
In the music industry, it's still very much this exploitative thing. It's still very much people signing their life away, you know, the old deal with the devil stuff.
Turn this down a little bit on the blue.
It's unbelievable in this day and age that that is still going on.
Look at this. This in Hollywood. Lined up to sell your soul, devil.
Tell us why you're here.
I'm going to sell my soul to the devil. What else? It's Hollywood. I want to be rich. I want to have everything.
My name is Chris.
My name is Matt Swinford.
My name is Sarah Caples.
My name is Kai.
My name is Peter Hansen.
A.K.A. The Dark Pool.
I'm a fashion stylist, and I'm here to sell my soul to Satan.
Ain't that something?
I answered the ad on selling your soul to Satan. Because I have some aspirations in life.
Now, all these people think this. That girl raised Catholic. And she said Satan wants everybody's soul, and that's true. But all of them think this. If I give Satan my soul, I'll get rich, I'll prosper. And the truth is, that very, very well may happen sometimes. You remember when Jesus was on the mountain there, and the devil said, all this I'll give you if you'll fall down and worship me. Now, the devil don't have all power to just give anything. But I tell you, somehow or another, the devil does make certain people rich because they're winning souls for him to take them to hell. That's true. Movie stars, girls, singers, all these ones I mentioned a minute ago, Katy Perry, little Billie Eilishes, whatever her name is, all them girls like that, the devil, they've made a trick. They made a deal with the devil, and the devil says, oh, you want to get rich? That's what these people are doing. Listen to them.
I wanted to marry a nice guy, and I wanted kids and a happy lifestyle, a comfortable lifestyle. I wanted to have a styling business, and I have all those things, and I'm really happy, thanks God. But the material things and the level of monetary gain that
money.
That part isn't coming through fast enough.
81% of young people polled by the Pew Research Center said getting rich was an important thing in life. Look at this.
I answered your ad out of curiosity mostly, but also because at this point in my life, I want some assurance that I'm going to succeed because I've come too close.
I want to succeed.
In my career choice.
I tell you, son, ain't much hope for you.
I really just need to ensure that I'm going to succeed, and that's the end of it.
Look at that. 51% said becoming famous was the most important thing in the world to them. I want to be famous. I want to be in Hollywood. Yeah, you better watch out. You've got a soul, and the devil will take it away from you, and you'll burn in hell forever and ever and ever. There's people doing it right now. Listen, you kids here tonight, you think here I am stuck in old Hickville, North Carolina, and here we are here and nobody in the mountains, and Lord have mercy. I want to tell you something. You ought to thank your lucky stars tonight and God Almighty. You know, that's his phrase. You ought to thank God tonight. You ought to thank God for your mom and daddy. You ought to thank God for a Bible-believing church and preacher that'll keep you out of hell, brother. You've got it made compared to most young people in this world. A lot of them grow up, go down this road, die and go to hell, and never even hear this. What's this?
Yeah, because I'm definitely intrigued about the entire subject matter. And
I'm intrigued by the subject matter of Satan selling your soul to Satan.
Doing it on television.
What is your price?
What is my price?
Yeah, because when you sell something,
what are you going to get for it?
And what is your price?
My price for selling my soul to the devil is wealth and power.
Wealth and power. He's a fool, man. He's a fool. You know what Jesus said? What shall it profit a man if he gain the whole world and lose his soul? He's a fool.
You have my own reality show.
Success in everything I've ever worked for. Absolute respect from people everywhere I go.
And I want to meet Janice Dickinson and Donald Trump.
That would be the price.
The number one thing people asked for was to be famous. Well, keep that door closed, please. Nobody asked for world peace. Nobody asked for revival. Just be faithful.
Why would the devil want your soul?
Why would the devil want your soul?
My soul, mostly because I really am a good person. Satan would like my soul because
he really
I
is
like
a good person.
Stand alone.
See, the devil done fooled him, son.
Why would the devil want my soul? I think because I have an innate ability to talk other people into following me down in a handbasket on a path to hell. He might like me because I'm a crowd gatherer.
I'm very entertaining to torture. I'm very entertaining when I'm in pain.
I'm very entertaining when I'm tortured. What are you, idiot? I'm not trying to be ugly. Set torque guy gas on that guy and set him on fire and see how entertaining he is. That's pitiful. That's pitiful. This is a businesswoman.
Satan would want my soul because the way I learned it in Catholic school is Satan wants everybody's soul.
That's true. He does.
Miss me. As long as I make history now, my soul is feeling empty. Tell the reaper to come and get
me. Should tell the reaper to come and get me. He said, all I care about is being happy. The devil lied to you about the consequences of your sin. He says, that's cool, brother. I love to dance and I love to get high and we love to drink. Let me tell you what you are, buddy. You are crazy. You are crazy. It'll get you in more trouble than you'll ever get out of. Hey, listen to me, girls. Y'all, every one of y'all, give your life to the Lord tonight in such a way that you'd tell every boy to go jump in Lake James. If he's not right with God, tell him to leave you alone. Boys, the same way. I don't care how pretty she is. I don't care how she can bat them eyelashes at you. They probably ain't real no way. I'm telling you, you make up your mind, hey, I'm going to live for God. I'm going to live for God. I'm not going to lose my soul over some old hussy. I'm not going to lose my soul over some old hot guy. I'm not going to do it. I'm going to make up my mind. I'm not going to be on drugs. I'm going to leave the drugs. I'm going to leave alcohol. I'm getting my life right with God here this evening. He lies about the consequences of your sin. And here's how he does it. He coats it in sugar because it sounds good. Listen to this. The road to hell is paved with good intentions. Listen to this. If I die tonight, at least I can say, tell me how about you? I did what I wanted to do. So Justin Timberlake, them saying, look, if we die tonight, who cares? As long as you did what you want to. That man's a fool to talk like that. You see how the devil is using him? Watch this. Read that. I got a feeling I'm about to act a fool. So go fix some drinks. And let's break some rules. See, that's how I get you. He'll get you out there somewhere. That music. That music is one of the most damnable things you could ever. And all you little kids, you don't realize. You just think, oh, it sounds good. I like that. Yeah, that's how they'll get you. Candy. It's candy. He ain't going to come up with pitchfork and horns and say, hey, I'm the devil. He ain't going to do that. He's going to get you something that sounds good, feels good, looks good, tastes good. That's what the devil does. Listen, read these words. Read these words to this song. Me and Usher are going about to break some rules. Got one life to live. I'm going to party till I'm dead. And what the blank is worth life worth living if it's not lived on the edge? I'll tell you what it is. A life worth living is one that's right with God and any family and love the Lord and get ready for heaven when you leave here. That guy's pitiful. Look at this. Boy's crazy. He said, I'm going to party till I'm dead. Write it on my tombstone. Women, weed, and alcohol. And the fool. What shall it profit a man if he gains? You got all the women, weed, and alcohol in the world, man, but you ain't going to take it with you. You're going to die without God and spend eternity in hell. That's the value of your soul is more important than poverty. Look at that. Lord, have mercy. How sad. Here's what the devil don't show you, kids. Here's what he don't show you. What he does show you is the party, the hot car, the good-looking guy, the beautiful girl. Here's what he don't show you that happens every night in this country. This. That's where the alcohol put you. They scream right before that. You don't come out of that. You don't come out of that. It's happening to some teenager tonight while we're sitting here in church. You think you're cool? You think you're so smart? You got it all figured out. Nobody can tell you nothing. You're the genius. You can steal your boyfriend, he drinks, but he's responsible. Okay. It is. That telephone pole, that car wrapped around that pole. That's somewhere in Florida or California. You see the palm trees. Them kids never knew what hit them. Can you imagine driving down the road? That could have been me, y'all. That could have been me that night we went to Asheville. And coming down the road, listening to music and driving around. We wasn't drinking. I've never drunk in my life. But we was acting stupid. And all it would have took would have been somebody to come over on our side of the road. Bam! I'd have been in hell right now. Right now. Look at this. My Lord. This girl's driving down the road. Her boyfriend's mad and he's drinking. This could be you, girls. If you get in a car with a guy that does drugs or drinks, watch what happens.
When are you gonna stop drinking and driving? After one of your friends gives you a dirty look?
Quit drinking.
You're gonna wait till a cop gives you a warning? Or is it just gonna be when you realize finally that losing your license could mean you losing your job? Or are you gonna have to run to a stop sign and...
She never knew what happened. She did. She never knew what had her. Now, I'm going to tell you something. God is speaking to somebody here tonight. When you going to stop? When you going to stop? When you going to get your head on right? Look at here tonight, kids. You know what alcohol and drugs will do to you? It'll ruin your life. You've all seen some of these pictures. All you girls in here, some of you are 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. You're healthy. Your skin's pretty. And this is what the devil will do to you. The devil will do this to you, kid. That's what it'll do to you. It don't take but a couple of years. You get on crystal meth, heroin, cocaine. Then you're gone. Then you're gone. It don't take long. Come on. You say, oh, Brother Danny, I just get high a little bit. I quit anytime I want to. That's what they thought. That's what they thought. You ought to make up your mind that that's not going to happen to me. By the grace of God, that's not going to happen to me. I'm not going down that road. I'm not going to live like that. I'm not going to do it. How many girls do we all know that's either went or going down that road right now? God's speaking to your heart here tonight. The devil will turn you from that to that. Look at that girl. And see what happens is some boy will tell you, I love you, I love you. And you'll do that to please him. And then the devil's got you hooked. Now, listen, I don't, I've never been on drugs, but if I was here tonight, you know what I'd do? I'd get in this altar and I'd say, God, I will never, by the grace of God, put nothing like that in my body. I'll go to rehab. I'll do whatever I got to do. I'll move out. I'll go somewhere else and live. I'll get help. There is help. There's help for you tonight, but you got to mean business. But you'll say, Lord, no matter what I got to do, I ain't going to end up like that. So that's what's going to happen to you. God speaking to your heart here tonight. Is God speaking to your heart here this evening? Is God speaking to you tonight? You let the Lord speak to you. Ain't nothing too hard for God. There ain't nothing too hard for God. You say, well, Brother Danny, I love my girlfriend and she does it, or I love my boyfriend and that. Sometimes you got to break your own heart. If I was you here tonight and I was a teenager, I'd get in this altar tonight and I'd say, God, by your grace, I ain't going to that crowd. I'm not going to live that way. I'm going to do what God wants me to do. While they sing, God speaking to your heart tonight. Amen. Y'all go ahead and sing tonight. Let's all stand. If God's dealing with you, you need to come and pray for yourself or a loved one. Just get in this altar tonight. Come on, go ahead. Amen.
It's out of your hands.
Amen. Amen. Come on, girls. That's right. Come on, young people. Come on, mama. Who are you girls? Ladies, pray for this girl here. Amen. That's right. That's right. Come on. Come on, girls. We need somebody to come pray with these bus girls here.
The prayer of faith.
Yeah, come on. Come on right now. Yeah, come on. Come on. Come on. Let's do business with God. Come on, mamas and daddies. Let's do business with God here tonight.
Is it?
Everybody sing now. Is anything too hard for God?
Come on now, say.
Who's got a problem beyond his power to solve? Other situations he's not the master of. Is anything too hard for God?
Sing it with him, everybody. Sing it with him, man. I'm glad there's nothing too hard for him tonight. Ain't no chain he can't break. There's no situation he can't straighten out.
Who's got
he can help you tonight if you'll let him. He'll help you tonight. Come on, let's get down here and pray. Get it right with God here tonight.
Situations, he's not the master of.
Pray.
Is anything too hard?
One more time. Sing now.
Is anything
too hard for God? No, there ain't nothing too hard for him.
Who's got a problem beyond his power to solve? Are there situations he's not the master of?
Is anything one more time
too hard?
That's everybody. Everybody sing it tonight. Is anything too hard? Say, is anything,
anything,
say it.
Too hard for God?
No, thank God, no, thank God.
Who's got a problem beyond his power to solve?
Are there situations?
Are there situations?
You're not the master of?
He's not the master of.
Lord.
Is anything hard for God?
She's playing softly tonight, so I'm still praying. Don't do it. Look, God wants your soul, and the devil wants your soul. And you're going to decide who's going to get it. You're going to decide who's going to get it. If you say, I want to be popular, I want everybody to like me, I want that guy, I want that girl, I want that, okay? Yeah, you can have it, but what'll it profit you if you get it all and lose your soul? If I was you, I'm so glad I got saved, man. I got saved when I was 18, buddy, and I gave my soul belongs to Jesus tonight. Glory to God, hallelujah. That decision was made a long time ago, and I sure wouldn't take nothing for it tonight. Some boys I went to school with, they done dead and gone. Already dead and gone. And that you'll be saying the same thing in a few years. And it goes by real quick. It goes by real quick. Is anything too hard for God? You say, I'm in a mess, preacher. Ain't nothing too hard for God. I'm in a situation I can't get out of. Listen, God, the Lord can change anything. He can help you if you'll let Him. I know people that are in that situation tonight, and they honestly think, I've talked to them, and they'll say, I'll say, you're going to die? Well, what if I do? Who cares? See, the devil's already got them convinced they can't get out. They can't stop. You're an addict. We all know people that they say, you're an addict. You can't stop. That's not true. He's a chain breaker, buddy. Amen? He really is. He's got the power to break whatever chain is holding you back tonight. God done something for somebody here tonight. I hope that it's you. Amen. Give me just a little more light, Jeff. Up here. All the way to the right. All the way to the right. Far, far right. On top and the bottom. There you go. Far, far right. There you go. No. The far, far right. Up above and below. Far as you can go to your right. This one's your right. It's okay. It's okay. I'll show you. It's okay. Now it's Christmas. If you'll turn them far, far right ones up, these will quit doing that. The ones on the far right. As far as you can go to the right. Over and there you go. There's one of them. Now below it. Right below it is the other one. Right below it. There you go. The far right. Remember that next time. I say that every time. What a blessing. See these young people getting right with the Lord. All right, and we're going to pray for you before you go. It's still early. So I want every one of you, 21 and under, I want every one of you, these little ones right here, the big ones up here, get up here behind me. We're going to pray for you. Come on right now. Come on, get up here. If you're 21 and under, I want you to get up here and stand with me tonight. Come on, 21 and under. Are y'all 21 and under? Yeah. See, 22? 21? Y'all 21 and under? Y'all not 21 and under? Death. 21 and under. Let's go. All right, now scoot over here. Y'all move over this way so we can see y'all. There you go. All right. All right, Karen. All right. Lordy mercy, I want you to look like a crowd of young people here just on a Sunday night at church. Isn't that a blessing? And a lot of these are our bus kids and come to church on buses. We thank the Lord for them. And we're going to pray for them tonight. I want you to pray for them. And I'm going to pray for them. And let's ask the Lord to help them tonight, okay? How many of y'all got to go to school tomorrow? Raise your hand. Lord, I feel sorry for you. That's awful. I feel sorry for anybody who's got to go to school. That's pitiful. Now, tonight, I want you to promise me that y'all pray. We're going to say something else here in a minute. I want y'all to promise me, them, that you'll pray for them. Okay? I want you to promise me that you'll pray for them. They need your prayers. Listen, without sounding too plain, we got kids up here that live in a bad, bad situation. Bad. It's a miracle that they're even here tonight. We got kids up here that live in a very good home. And we got kids that just, it's a miracle they're here. Thank God for bus workers. Thank God for bus workers. Oh, y'all, you better thank the Lord for your bus worker. You better thank the Lord, because if it wasn't for your bus work, some of y'all would never even see what you've seen here tonight. And most kids, look, there's kids all over California and Hollywood and everything. If they saw what you saw tonight, they'd say, I'm going to live for God the rest of my life. They would. They would. They'd say that. So you better watch this attitude of, oh, yeah, another youth night. Here we go. The devil will get you. He'll get you and spit you out down the road somewhere. So get this in your heart. I want all of you to take one of these here tonight before you go, take it to school, put it on your locker. If anybody says something to you, sue them. We need the money. I'm just kidding. But everybody else, I mean, you can do that. You can take these to school, be a witness for the Lord, invite somebody. And they're like, okay, so we're going to pray for you. Anybody want to say something? If you want to say something right now, good time to say it. We're just getting warmed up for youth rally. This is just getting us started for youth rally. You're going to bring all your friends to the youth rally. That day we're going to have food, four-wheeler rides, and razor, and everything else. Going to have a great time, okay? Does anybody want to say something right quick? And then we're going to pray with you. Anybody? Okay? Now's your chance. You feel like your heart's doing like that? You're the one that should be talking. Anybody? Anybody here? Right here. All right? Okay? All right. Let's bow our heads and pray. I want you to stay up here. Everybody bow your head. Heavenly Father, I do thank you for every one of these young people here tonight. I pray, oh, dear Lord, that you'd work in every single heart as only you can do. Lord, I can't do it, but you can. We can't do it, but you can. I pray you bless these young people, these girls, these boys, as they go back to school tomorrow, have your way in their lives. Watch over them, and God will thank you for it. God, give them strength, and especially whoever it is up here that's struggling in something that they're trying to get out of and need to get out of, God, give them the grace and the strength to do it. I ask in Jesus' name and for his sake. Amen. All right, stay right there. Go ahead, Jeff. Well, we got you something here tonight. We got a little surprise for you. Get the rest of the lights back there for me now, Wes. Now, we got a little surprise for you tonight, and when you leave, Tyler, why don't you help me out here a little bit?
Brandon, yeah, grab some of these. We'll give everybody one of these here tonight. All the kids, when they come down here, we have a surprise for you tonight. And before you go, and you're wrong because you thought it was Pepsi. You are wrong. And it should be because Pepsi is my best drink. But tonight, we have Mountain Dew and we have Code Red Mountain Dew. That looks like something that's good for you right there. And then we have Dr. Pepper. So you get a Dr. Pepper, Code Red, Mountain Dew, and we have Baby Ruth's. So I think we get two of these each. Not you, Toes. You ain't 21. Where you think you're going? All right. If you're not 20, if you're not up here, you don't get one. So we're going to get you one of these. Code Red. That right there will help you go to sleep tonight about 4 o'clock. And these Baby Ruths are good. I like Baby Ruth, don't y'all? And everybody gets two Baby Ruths. So let's ask the blessing on this. Lord, I pray you bless these Mountain Dews and these Dr. Peppers and these Baby Ruths and watch over these kids and take everybody home safe tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, let's go. Let's go. You get your choice. Two Baby Ruths. What you want? What you want? Manhattan gets anything she wants here. Anybody want regular Mountain Dew? Regular Mountain Dew? Anybody want Mountain Dew here? All right, Isaac. Isaac gets whatever he wants here because he's